this is the bottle. Yeah. And this, I mean, again, like this came from a lot of learning over 2018 about like, hey, the beverage space is super competitive. The wellness space is super competitive. And like the brand that we're trying to build is this one of accessibility and cheerfulness and inclusiveness. And like, how do we get the packaging to convey that? And, you know, I didn't have a lot of funding in the beginning. So like, we didn't have a ton of money to spend on, you know, an agency. The idea for the blue bottle came from me sitting at bars, you know, when I was probably supposed to be talking to my friends, looking at spirits on the shelf and being like, wow, those bottles are really beautiful. How do I bring that alive or bring that to life? So, you know, it was scrappy in the beginning.
That's really fascinating because in some way you have to educate the market as well, right? And so the way I think about when brands roll out packaging, it's like you have to pick one. Either you're picking something that grabs them. So if it's pretty or if it looks appealing or if it just pops, let's say it just pops on the shelf, then you've hooked me. But yeah. Then there's another layer of it where, and this is really interesting because brands can literally decide how they decide to attack the market. And so is it education first? Is it hook them with the product first, have them taste it, and now the education sinks in? Especially I think from probably where you were coming from, when maybe you were a little bit early to market, let's say, or an early mover in this specific category, right? Do you see it the same way?
Yeah, I think, and again, this came from a lot of learning, but one of the things that we've really tried to make easy for people is like, you know, the blue is going to pull you in, and the names of the flavors, which is arguably the only other thing you'll probably see because you spend all of 1 second, 2 seconds, right, looking, is going to be very easy for you to understand. So like, it's going to be detox ginger, right? You probably know what detox means and you probably have an experience with ginger. And then hopefully you enjoy the product from a taste perspective for how it makes you feel. And then as you're digging in further, and especially for the consumer that really does understand the herbs, you're turning it over and you're like, wow, you know, this product is incredibly clean and they use dandelion root and they use burdock root. Like, I wonder what those things are. And if you want to go into that depth as a consumer, like the information, and I think the credibility is there from the Sunwink perspective. Like, we work with herbalists to craft each blend, right? Like, there's a lot of information on our website about those herbs, but we try not to throw it all at you at once because we recognize that one is probably not going to get your attention, and two, it can feel intimidating, right? So like, start with the beautiful packaging, a simple name and great taste, and then go from there.